There you have it. Aidan Keener and Mallory Martin have been recalled back to Hearts. And is our season over? I maybe wouldn't go that far yet, but will we struggle to score goals even more now? That's more of a possibility. Of course, it's been well documented really that we have struggled to score goals this season, and especially in the striking departments, we've certainly not really brought in players that have ended up equating to the amount of goals that we would have wanted to score. And not having a player even really near double figures so far this season isn't exactly what we would have wanted at this point in the season. Obviously in the league it's even less than what it currently is. The kind of records that I've got on my phone are to do with in all competitions, and I think our highest goal scorers on 6 goals, and that's Miles Hippolyte. And then obviously in the league it's even less than that, because obviously he's scored goals in cup competitions and stuff like that. We've got players like Faisal, Robbie Muirhead, Hippolyte himself, Louis Longridge, and Andy Ryan as well. Obviously he's out longer term with an injury, but those three were players, that's the ones we're left with now due to Aidan Keener being recalled to Hearts. And as I mentioned, it's not exactly the best thing for us, albeit he didn't score a barrelload of goals for us, but he was the only one that really looked very likely to just score from out of nothing really. In his debut, I think it was, up against Inverness, or at least it was one of his first games for us anyway, he scored that fantastic goal to open the scoring for us. And that's just what Aidan Keener was all about, just shooting from anywhere really. And you always had the feeling that there was a chance that he could at least get it on target and bring something for us. And the fact that we've now lost him and he's going back to Hearts, it just kind of, it really screams that we do need some form of striker in this window. And I don't know if it'll happen. I would assume that it will happen, because Stevie Crawford said in his interview last night that he feels that the squad at the moment needs an injection of something, and that probably does mean it needs an injection of goals or creativity or something like that. So I would imagine we will bring in one signing, but I wasn't exactly really thinking that Aidan Keener was going to get recalled back to Hearts. I thought that he would have saw out the season with us, and that would have been that. As I said, Mallory Martins went back as well, and for all that he was obviously an option in the squad, I don't think that this one is going to be as big a miss as Aidan Keener will be. Martin obviously came off the bench at the weekend there, so Stevie Crawford was utilising him in a way, but the fact that Hearts have recalled him, I don't think it's the end of the world for us really, because he was a kind of player that we didn't really utilise as much as Aidan Keener and other players in the squad. And we do have midfield options now, and Mallory Martin's one of the kind of lower reaches of those midfield options, and I don't really think he is needed 100% in this squad. Aidan Keener, however, as I've mentioned, was a vital member of the squad, and that's why we 100% need to try and replace him in some form, whether that be before Saturday's game against Raith Rovers, where if we go in without a replacement for him, and obviously we're now going into it without Aidan Keener himself, then we're going into it looking really light up top in terms of actual goals this season, in terms of confidence in the actual strikers. For example, if Robbie Muirhead plays, he's barely played up front this season for one, and obviously secondary to that, he's barely scored a goal, or he's not scored a goal, I can't even remember if I'm honest, but there's certainly not been many to remember for Robbie Muirhead, and that goes for basically all the strikers so far. Faisal's got 3, and that's in all competitions. That he obviously got his brace in his debut against Brechin, his second debut, and he's only got 1 in the league so far, and that came last month against Morton. So, as I've mentioned, Andy Ryan being out long-term injured doesn't help as well, but we don't have strikers that are firing on all cylinders, and that is the main problem that we've had all season so far. And for all that the squad looks good on paper and stuff like that, they've not been firing to the expectations that we thought they would be. When Faisal came in, for example, we expected him to be better than he has been, for all that we didn't expect him to be the 30 goal a season striker that he was in his previous spell with us. We did probably expect better quality than we have gotten so far this season. Andy Ryan, he's been a bit of a letdown so far. He's not exactly had a lot of chances, but then when he has, he's not really shown up to be the kind of striker that we all hoped as well. We hoped he could maybe replace Nicky Clark. He's done nothing of the sort. And as I've mentioned previously, Robbie Muirhead, Callum Smith as well. I just don't think they're quite up to the calibre of player that we do need right now. And that's why I do think that with Aidan Keane now being recalled to Hearts, which was the worst possible outcome for us, we do 100% need to bring in someone now. And I don't know if the finances really dictate for it, because as I mentioned, Stevie Crawford mentioned it in his interview last night, said that it might take one going out, one coming in. If one does come in, then one will need to go out, basically. And the finances are kind of at a stage where that does need to be the scenario. I just hope that we can do something, because seeing out this season, having barely scored any goals, and that was with Aidan Keane in the squad, albeit he was injured for the first 6 weeks when he arrived, we do need to bring in something that's going to inject that bit of goals and creativity, at least, into our play, because if we keep going on like this for the rest of the season, I think we'll be mostly relying on Falkirk and Partick Thistle being just as bad as the first half of the season. And if you're relying on other teams, then that's obviously not great. The performance at the weekend was a good start, but that was with Aidan Keane playing 65 minutes in that game, and Stevie Crawford himself said that Aidan Keane ran his socks off and did exactly what he wanted him to do, and now he doesn't have Aidan Keane as an option in the squad. So I would imagine that Stevie Crawford himself will be wanting another option as a striker for the rest of the season. Will he get it? Will he get it before this weekend's game? Because it'll be a massive marker to set down for Stevie Crawford if he can go and win the derby game. But can we do that with the current crop of strikers that we have at the moment and the lack of goals that we have in the side? It's a difficult one to call. I really hope that we can bring someone in. If we don't bring someone in before the weekend, then it has to happen before the end of the January window. This was a kind of impromptu video again, because it seems like nothing can be kept quiet at Dunfermline recently, because obviously the last week on the managerial stuff, and now our key player has now returned to his parent club, which kind of says it all about our season, that we really were relying on a player that wasn't even our player to start off with. But aye, that's it for this video guys, cheers for watching. If you did enjoy, please give it a like, comment down below what you think we should do about this. Do you think we have to bring in a striker before Saturday? Or do you think we won't bring any strikers in or any sort of players in at all this window? Which, in my opinion, would just be absolutely disastrous for us. And subscribe for more of this type of content. Thank you so much for 800 subscribers. Bye. Until the next video, which will be Punt It Long tomorrow. I'll see you then. Cheers, guys.